Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Here in Indy and all around the league, we mourn the loss of the iconic John Madden, coach, broadcaster, and so much more, whose legacy will live forever. Moments ago, a moment of silence held here as well as at every NFL stadium this weekend. Frank Reich told us John Madden impacted everyone who loves the game of football. There's Mark Davis, Raiders owner, head coach Rich Bisaccia. John Madden had a bigger-than-life personality, charisma. He transcended the game.
He was a true living legend. You think of football, you immediately thought of John Madden. I'm up here in the booth because of him, trying to emulate him, because he did it second to none. Rest in peace.
Passed away this past week at the age of 85. Colts won the toss. They defer. So the team that John Madden coached to a Super Bowl championship will get the ball first out to Sarah.
Well, Carson Wentz is going to start at quarterback today after going on the COVID list on Tuesday. But because of changing protocols, he was allowed to return after 5 days. I spoke to him this morning. He told me he feels 100% fine, said he felt tired earlier in the week. He described this week as really weird, being at home while your team is trying to clinch a playoff berth. Kenny, you know Derek Carr said nothing else matters, though, for this Raiders team if they don't win.
Both teams control their own destiny. Great news for the Colts with the return of Carson Wentz. Thanks, Sarah. Raiders start from the 25-yard line, and Josh Jacobs, coming off a big game last week, takes it out across the 30 for a gain of 7. Derek Carr trailing only Tom Brady and Justin Herbert in the category of passing yards this season.
And it's really impressive. When you lose Henry Ruggs, you lose Waller, two of your best receivers, he's still able to find the production, get down the field with the football, and press the defense.
Second down and 3. Carr over the middle. It's complete for a first down. Hunter Renfrow, who leads the Raiders with 93 receptions, gain of 14, as we check out the Las Vegas offensive line.
Yeah, and speaking of Hunter Renfrow, when the production wasn't there with losing Darren Waller and losing Henry Ruggs, there was your guy. He picked up the slack more than just that slot receiver. He's able to really get open on the routes and starting to find himself now getting double teamed. So you think of a Wes Welker type Julian Edelman, that's Hunter Renfrow.
Waller missing his 5th consecutive game on first down. It's Jacobs, gain of 2. Kari Willis made the tackle as we check out the Colts defense.
Yeah, and this defense, I can't talk enough about how well they have improved. And you start looking at some of the Pro Bowlers, one of note is Kenny Moore. I call him Sweet Feet Kenny, man. He's got the best feet that I've seen in a long, long time. I think of Patrick Peterson, the way he had quick feet, and it was a well-deserved Pro Bowl for Kenny Moore.
I thought that was your nickname for me.
No, you don't have sweet feet.
Catch is made by Zay Jones in Colts territory.
Yeah, I got you some sweet cleats.
You did a couple of weeks
ago. You don't
back.
Have sweet feet. Big difference.
Well, Kenny Moore having an outstanding season, leading the team with 4 picks.
Yeah, and they were so happy for him. His whole team was excited. Says he literally leaves it on the field, leaves it all on practice, goes 110 miles an hour, everything he does. And I love watching this matchup. He's going to be in that slot, really able to cover one-on-one against Zay Jones or Hunter Renfrow. There's a Kenny Moore matchup. I'm looking forward to this one.
3rd down and 3. Carr throws near side. It is caught by Renfrow for a Raiders first down.
And that's this good on good. Hunter Renfrow, he's going to be right in the slot, going to go up, option route, break outside. Kenny Moore, he has to play to his leverage. You notice Kenny Moore stayed inside first, jumped inside to make sure that Hunter Renfrow didn't beat him across the field. Carr and Renfro have been on the same page for the past 8-9 weeks now. This is going to be a really exciting matchup to see all game.
Hey, Lynn.
New set of downs for the Raiders. Two tight ends set from the Colts 41. Carr, pump fake, throws. Renfro again. And a nice tackle made by Xavier Rhodes. Third catch for Renfro. Gain of three. We mentioned Waller remains out on the defensive side. Hankins and the Colts without some key players as well.
Yeah, we would be remiss if we didn't say Pro Bowler Darren Waller, because that's how impactful he's been on the game and for the Colts offense.
And zebra, zebra, zebra.
Raiders, excuse me.
Susan.
Second down and seven. Jacobs cuts to the outside. And is tackled about a yard and a half shy of the marker by Bobby Okereke. Season highs in attempts and rush yards for the Raiders last week. 129 for Jacobs.
And I loved how Josh Jacobs was so candid with us. He said at halftime, he literally went up to offensive coordinator Greg Olsen and said, hey, let us run the ball more than once or twice at a time, three or four times at a time, so we can start to wear down the defense. Second half, that's exactly what they did, and you saw the production, and they got the victory.
Jalen Richard in the backfield, third down and one. Here's Richard, his first carry, and it's another first down for the Las Vegas Raiders to the Colts 27-yard line.
Yeah, and I'm really liking the game plan. This is a carryover from last week against the Broncos, where they've been running the ball. As soon as you bring that safety down, you'll start to see that they pass outside to these one-on-one option routes with Hunter Renfro. And there's Greg Olsen, to his credit, listened to exactly what his team was saying. Josh Jacobs said, we can run the ball on these guys. Let's do it. They did it, had success, and are bringing it back again this week.
53.
Ninth play of the drive. Blazers lasted 5 minutes on the 27-yard line as Carr connects with Jacobs out of the backfield. Nice move to stay in bounds, and he has another Raiders first down. Gain of 11.
A really good-looking drive for the Raiders to start the game. Right now, they have this Colts defense off balance. They've been getting the ball out to the perimeter, had success there, and then have been running it right down the teeth of this Colts defense. See the play selection, nice balance.
Carr has completed his first five pass attempts.
Hey, no, kill.
From the Colts 17, it's Jacobs. And Jacobs gains six more, down to the 11 before he was tackled by George Odom.
Here's Josh Jacobs wincing just a little bit.
Here comes Marcus Mariota onto the field. Carr in the huddle as well.
Yeah, no surprise. The Raiders have done this all season long. Marcus Mariota very, very good at the RPO run pass option.
Carr
down at the bottom of the screen.
Split out wide to the left. Second down and four. Mariota keeps it inside the five. Down to the Colts one.
Out he goes, and exactly what we said, zone read. Marcus Mariota has been doing this since his Oregon days, made a living off of it. Nice cutoff of Foster Moreau, getting north and south, and now you're looking at the Raiders knocking on the door, first and goal in the 2-yard line. And I would love to see them just pound this right in.
What is it?
On first and goal, it's Jacobs. And he is in for a Raiders touchdown. A 7-minute opening drive. Las Vegas strikes first.
Look, all the bodies to the left. What Josh Jacobs doesn't get credit for is that he is awesome with his jump cut. As soon as he gets the ball, notice his shoulders square, and as soon as he sticks his foot in the ground, he's jump cutting, getting right back north and south. I mean, that's almost impossible for Isaiah Rodgers to make that tackle on the goal line. What a drive. What a start for the Raiders offense.
Daniel Carlson adds the extra point. 12 plays. Over 7 minutes. Jacobs into the end zone.
This year, make good on your resolution to join a community that knows no bounds. Gather with more friends, experiencing places unknown. And become part of a family that knows the best adventures are the ones we share. Embrace each day, knowing that no matter where you go, it'll be one you never forget.
Shop and buy online with Jeep eShop, where right now, get 0% financing for 72 months on select 2021 Jeep Grand Cherokee models.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
It is all about T-Mobile with their great phone deals for everyone every day, including customers on Sprint. Tell us more, Diane.
New and existing customers on the Magenta Max plan can trade up to the new iPhone 13 Pro, and T-Mobile will pay for it. Customers can also get a free year of Apple TV Plus. I know you love Ted Lasso, George.
Guilty as charged. T-Mobile is bringing it all together for the holidays.
Upgrade to the iPhone 13 Pro on us. Plus, get a free year of Apple TV Plus only at T-Mobile.
At Lowe's, with endless ways to organize what you need, you'll find some of the peace of mind you want at prices you really want. Start the year fresh at Lowe's. Shop Lowe's Store and Save event now, in-store and online.
The BK $5 Your Way meal is here to make your choice easy and so tasty. Go straight to the Double Whopper Jr. with piping hot small fries, four-piece crispy nuggets, and a refreshing small drink. Can you believe you get all this for only $5? The $5 Your Way meal, only at Burger King.
What's the fallout from WWE Day 1 and what's next for the Universal Champion Roman Reigns? Find out on the first SmackDown of the new year, live this Friday at 8 Eastern on Fox.
Today's game is sponsored by Burger King. Get the $5 Your Way meal with the Double Whopper Jr.
That's the greatest feeling in the world. That's what it's all about.
Pat Summerall here with John Madden.
You always got this. You always know how much time there is. And boom! Now you're talking. I mean, this is football.
Football is my life.
In honor of the great John Madden, his image will now replace Fox, upper right-hand corner of your screen, because without him, Fox Sports would not be what it has become.
Right about that, Kenny.
Hired along with Pat Summerall when Fox Sports acquired the rights to the NFC package. Prior to the 1994 season, his former team, the Raiders, begin this game with a 12-play, 75-yard touchdown drive.
Yeah, there's no better way to honor him if you're the Raiders to go right down, march down the field, score on this very good Colts defense.
Isaiah Rodgers is deep. Raiders out to a 7-0 lead. Short kickoff taken at the 6 by Rodgers across the 25. Out to the 28-yard line. So as Sarah talked about, Carson Wentz in health and safety protocol throughout the week, but he has been cleared. Sam Ellinger was ready to go just in case. And Wentz and the Colts offense have gotten off to some great starts this season.
Yeah, so if there's any offense that can really get it going and match what the Raiders did, this is going to be Carson Wentz, Jonathan Taylor. Frank Wright calls a really good game. Really love the fact of how he has incorporated the passing game within that run game.
Six opening drive touchdowns. Second in the league, split backs. Taylor and Hines, and this is Hines on the first carry. Perriman made the tackle.
Yeah, and the face of the franchise, Jonathan Taylor, he makes cuts that you don't see other running backs do. Two guys are in the hole, and he's able to sideswipe two really good defenders. You just see him get skinny. Most running backs would just try to run him over. And this is what I love. Jonathan Taylor knows I have to make one guy miss. Well, he's so comfortable now, he's making two guys miss, right? The one safety and then Buda Baker, he makes miss as well, who's a really good safety in his own right. Jonathan Taylor coming into his own as a phenom.
On the toss, here's Taylor, who leads the NFL in rushing by over 450 yards.
It's almost not fair.
Now the Colts are without their two-time Pro Bowl left tackle, Eric Fisher, today. So Matt Pryor makes the start.
And they started to have some success on the outside with Michael Pittman. Him and Wentz have really started to develop a relationship, and I love his size-speed combination out of USC, and I always admired the way that he used his ability and his size and his ability to go get the football, starting to do that now in the NFL.
Third down and 10. Colts must get to the 37 for a first down. Wentz under pressure, fires over the middle, and it is broken up by Casey Hayward, so the Colts go three and out.
Up front first, Max Crosby, Pro Bowl defensive end Max Crosby. They have loved this TE stunt, tackle end stunt, where he knifes back inside, puts pressure on Carson Wentz, and because of that, it's a delayed throw across the middle of the field, and Casey Hayward, he's made a living off that for years.
Hayward, a two-time Pro Bowler. Sanchez punts it away. Renfrow moving to his right, up the sideline, and then knocked out of bounds. Good field position for the Raiders after their defense holds. Colts three and out.
I don't care about any award show. I haven't seen my Clio in a week.
It's the industry's highest honor.
My queen. My beautiful queen.
Caesar, what are you doing?
A romantic evening of tacos and chill.
Here's your acceptance speech. Do not improvise.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are all Caesars. Pause for ovation.
Not that part.
When I was but a young Caesar.
Didn't I say don't improvise?
I've got that blue sky. I've got that sunshine.
This crazy suit gonna give me an edge?
Oh, yeah. Huge edge.
Invisibility gives Aaron Donald an edge on his game.
Who hit me?
Just like a verified approval gives you an edge on your offer.
I did.
When you need a competitive edge in the housing game, Rocket can.
Come seek the Royal Caribbean.
There's still time to enter your Fox Super 6 picks for a chance at $100,000 of Terry's money. Download the app now and play for free.
Today's game is sponsored by Coors Light, made to chill.
Raiders lead 7-0. Like the Colts, they control their own destiny. It's been a whirlwind of a season. They started 3-0, a couple of wins in overtime. And then, of course, the coaching change. Rich Bisaccia replaced John Gruden. Waller missing his fifth consecutive game. They had a 1-5 stretch, but have won their last two. Have not had a winning season since 2016. Bisaccia has held things together. He's done a terrific job. He gives a lot of credit to his entire coaching staff. Three former NFL head coaches on the Raiders staff.
Yes, and they all have input. They've all helped out Bisaccia. And it's a testament to him and the coaching staff. They could have easily caved 6-7. Instead, they win two on the cusp here, trying to win and get a playoff berth.
Big tackle after the catch was made by Jacobs. Zaire Franklin, loss of two.
On the cusp here, trying to win and get a playoff berth. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. That's the intensity. Zaire Franklin laying the boom.
180. Is it hot? Hot, hot. Hey, hey. Hey, J-Lo, Phil Mickelson.
You gotta go 37.
Phil Mickelson.
Hey, boy, boy.
J-Lo.
G2.
Here we go. Seals it.
Second down and 12. This is Jacobs. Out across the 40 to the 42-yard line. Gain of 9. Jacobs with the game's first touchdown.
Yeah, he's still wincing, though.
It's Mark Davis. Son of the Hall of Famer, the late Al Davis.
That's him.
Who hired John Madden to coach the Raiders at the age of 32.
That was a great hire. Unbelievable success. Brought them their first Super Bowl. Mark Davis looking to try to repeat that success.
Third down and 3. Carr fires downfield, looking for Deshaun Jackson. It is picked off. Isaiah Rogers with the interception. Rogers goes up and gets it. Third pick of the season.
Hey there, you getting some gas?
Just using your squeegee.
Well, the squeegee kind of comes with gas.
Squeegee isn't free?
Oh, it's free with gas.
Yeah, but it's a plug-in hybrid. I don't need gas.
Well, no gas, no squeegee.
No gas, no squeegee?
No gas, no squeegee.
No gas, no squeegee.
Now free squeegee.
Now free squeegee.
Evolve your journey beyond the pump in the first ever Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EV.
This holiday, Verizon has the deal that gets better and better and better.
Get iPhone 13 Pro on us when you trade in your old or damaged phone.
Better.
Better.
Hey, and up to $1,000 when you switch. Better. Because everyone deserves better.
Pizza Hut's stuffed crust is the crust that made crust good. Topped and stuffed with over a half pound of cheese. What are you so afraid of? Loving it? Original stuffed crust, just $12.99, only from Pizza Hut. No one out pizza the Hut.
Wasn't me.
You're never responsible for unauthorized purchases on your Discover card.
911, what's your emergency?
You're as cold.
"911 Lone Star" season premiere tomorrow on Fox.
The legendary dating show is back. Joe Millionaire premieres this Thursday on Fox.
Today's game is sponsored by Pizza Hut. No one outpizzas the Hut.
It's time to celebrate. Not only the new year, but Fox Super 6 has given away over $6 million in cash prizes. You still have a chance to win, Jonathan, even more money. Scan the QR code. Enter Fox Super 6's Sunday Challenge for a free chance at $100,000. It's not too late to enter, so play now.
Oh, you have no idea how I've been trying, but that's the matchup. And it was actually the right read by Derek Carr. You see the safety drop down. Kyrie Willis, no chance of getting to that fade route. Ball was a little underthrown, but I love the way Isaiah Rogers played that like a wide receiver. He goes up, turns around, locates the football just like Deshaun Jackson, reaches up, goes for it, and gets it in. Yeah, they're celebrating. After that first drive, Colts rebounding with the interception, getting their offense right back on the field.
Colts 30-second takeaway, only the Cowboys have more.
That'll win you a lot of games.
Colts went 3 and out on their opening possession. Here's Jonathan Taylor. Taylor pulled down just shy of the 30-yard line by Perryman. Gain of 4.
Here's Denzel Perryman, Max Crosby, two Pro Bowlers. Really have stepped up, stopping the run. Faced two good running teams the past 2 weeks. Yeah, they had their backup quarterbacks, but the point was they needed to find a way to stop the run. They got that done defensively.
Gotcha. Second down and six. Keep it on the ground with Taylor as we head to Los Angeles for a game break. Carissa.
Thank you, Kenny. Chiefs, Bengals. Chiefs clinch home field advantage with a win and a Titans loss. Mahomes airs this one out. Robinson, recipient 29-yard touchdown. Kansas City up early on the Bengals, 7-0. Kenny.
That's Carissa. Chiefs, the only AFC team guaranteed in the postseason. 24 teams around the league remain alive. Incredible.
That is incredible.
Hey, five two.
Also, what they fought through all season long, struggled middle of the season, have been on a tear the last part of the season.
From the 36 on first down, play action, and then Wentz throws it into the turf.
Yeah, they were trying to set up a screen to Jonathan Taylor, and defense all over it. There's head coach Frank Reich. He's done a masterful job all season long. What I loved is when we spoke to him, there was no real point in the season where he said, oh, it just clicked. He said, we just needed time on task. A lot of the guys were injured. Wentz, remember, didn't play much of the preseason. And now you're seeing a team that's gelled and can run the football.
Empty backfield, second and 10. Wentz to the outside, and that's off the hands of the antenna receiver, T.Y. Hilton, with Faison defending.
Yeah, nice break on the ball. Brandon Faison, he read that like a book, and you got to give T.Y. Hilton his respect. He's so fast. So to be able to break up on the football the way Faison did, I mean, that's tremendous. So we see the first quarter points differential. The Colts have been outstanding all season long. They also take care of the football. Second and turnover margin. This third and long, they're going to have to find a way to beat this man coverage.
Third down and 10. Wentz can't find anyone. That was Braden Smith, the right tackle. And now a flag is thrown.
I think he thought about it, then realized I can't touch it. It's illegal touching. There's the Pro Bowler, Max Crosby, getting the pressure. Quentin Jefferson helping out, and then Braden Smith is looking like, well.
There's no foul for intentional grounding. 28 was in the area. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah. He's like, well, what do you want me to do with this?
So they picked up the flag. Brad Rogers, our referee, and the Colts unable to capitalize. Following the Rogers interception, they will punt it away. Renfro back deep. Raiders out to a 7-0 lead here in Indianapolis.
And the Raiders have done a tremendous job taking the crowd out of it. You can hear a pin drop in here. I mean, this is exactly what you want if you're the Raiders.
Sanchez punting from his 25. Fielded at the 24 by Renfro. Renfro out across midfield. Down the sideline, and it's the punter, Sanchez, who finally knocks him out of bounds after a 41-yard return.
Oh, yeah. Did we mention he's pretty good as a punt returner, too? Hunter Renfro doing it all for the Raiders. Soon as he gets it, makes first guy miss, and then he is shooting to the outside. Look at those blocks lined up for him as he gets down the sideline. And look, there is one team that came to play. So far, it's the Raiders. You take away that long interception, and it's been all Raiders all quarter.
Longest career punt return and the longest by a Raider this season. Josh Jacobs went into the medical tent earlier. Peyton Barber in the backfield takes the handoff from Carr, and he goes nowhere, bottled up at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, that's going to be a big miss, or a big loss, excuse me, for the running bank, for the running game, for the Las Vegas Raiders if Jacobs can't come back. We're watching Jacobs.
That's earlier in the first quarter.
Yeah, it takes a knee to that right arm.
Barber, again, nothing.
Yeah, it's just not the same.
Let's check in with Sarah.
Well, Kenny, we saw Josh Jacobs actually leave the field. He went into the locker room. I'm told he's dealing with a ribs issue and is probable. You've seen him take a couple of tough hits today already, Kenny.
All right, thanks, Sarah. We'll keep an eye on that situation.
Yeah, that's tough. I don't even know how you protect the ribs as a running back. You're going to get tackled from all different angles. That's going to be tough. Hopefully he can come back.
Third down and 10. Richard in the backfield. As Carr throws, it is caught. And a first down. Zay Jones to the 24-yard line of the Colts. Gain of 11.
And Zay Jones is another wide receiver for the Raiders who stepped up, working on man coverage, Isaiah Rodgers. And this is what I like. As soon as he gets the ball, he was short of the first down. This becomes an individual effort. As soon as he catches it, he's about 2 or 3 yards short. No dancing, just puts two hands on the football and gets up the field for the first.
Final minute, first quarter. Raiders on the move following the big punt return by Renfro. Peyton Barber to the 22-yard line. Gain of 3.
There's Rich Bisaccia, interim head coach, has done a really good job managing the team. He always says, look, I'm not going to go and try to interfere with the offense or defense. Special teams is what I do. But I need to know that we're playing complementary football, and so far they have.
On second down, here's Barber. And he is met in the backfield by DeForest Buckner. Buckner heading to his second Pro Bowl, and that will do it for the first quarter here in Indianapolis. Carson Wentz returns, big opening drive for Derek Carr and the Raiders. Race. Colts in with a win today. Raiders in with 2 wins. Neither team eliminated with a loss today.
The best is they control their own destiny. That's what I love about when I played. You had to control your own destiny come late December, January. If you were there, you did something right. It may not be winning the division, but Frank Reich, for them to start 0-3 and just fight their way into this position, you've got to give hats off to them.
We begin the second quarter with the Raiders leading 7-0. Third down and 12 for Las Vegas. Carr moving to his right, wrapped up. Down he goes. Quinny Pay leading the way, the rookie out of Michigan.
And Derek Carr was really looking for Hunter Renfro this time. Kenny Moore gets the better of him, right? He stays square the whole time. I told you about those sweet feet he has. Took him too long to get into that break, and you see Derek Carr staring him down. Nope. Let me just hold on to the football. Nice job all around. Good defense. Nice awareness by Carr not to have a turnover on that sack.
Daniel Carlson, 47-yard attempt. Carlson's kick is good, and the Raiders extend to a 10-0 lead. Set up by the big punt return by Renfro, short field. Raiders capitalize.
911, what's your emergency?
I have been in a car accident. My car slipped. There's water getting in the car, and I can't get out.
911, what is your emergency?
I came off paddle boarding and a hard wind is pushing me out to sea.
Okay, do not hang up.
911, what's your emergency?
I'm here at the farm. I broke my leg straight down 21 feet. I sure need help quick.
Are you by yourself?
Yes.
Have you tried to get out? You tried to bust the window or something?
I'm pretty far out in the ocean.
I can't get to my cell phone. I'm talking on my Apple Watch.
Try to keep talking to me.
Okay.
I can't fight the wind anymore.
It's getting deeper. It's getting to my neck.
Please hurry. I'm hurting real bad.
You're going to see help, okay?
I see them.
They're opening the door.
Hold on. Are you in an air pocket?
I'm just at the driver's seat.
Okay, so you're headed above water?
Yes, sir.
It's time for electric to turn into lightning. An electric truck that can haul on both ends, that can help build your house, and if need be, power that house. That feels like a bullet train and works like a freight train. The fully electric F-150 Lightning.
Seton Hall clashes with UConn, and Michigan State battles Michigan. College Hoops tip off Saturday at 11:30 Eastern on Fox.
Want more stats? Just ask Siri, who leads the league in receiving touchdowns.
Tonight after football, it's the premiere of Gordon Ramsay's biggest cooking competition ever. 15 of the best chefs in America in a massive three-story culinary gauntlet. Don't miss Next Level Chef premiering tonight after the NFL on Fox.
Yeah, and then no one's going to know this, but Kenny brings in this slop into the booth. I was like, ew, what is this? We got fried jalapenos right there. I think that's what that is. Some nasty-looking bacon right there. All of it equals terrible. No thank you, Kenny. No thanks. Did you eat that slop, Kenny?
You're giving away my secrets.
That's terrible. You need some gum. I'm going to get you some gum because I know your breath is kicking.
After all of your seasons in New Orleans, you learn well after eating many dinners at the fine restaurants down south.
Exactly, the good stuff. That is no bueno.
We'll save you some for halftime.
I'll pass, thanks. Just give me my little fruit cup over there or something.
Coach Madden would have loved it.
He really would have. Would he have eaten the hot dog?
Absolutely. Heard an interview with Commissioner Roger Goodell this week, and he would travel with John Madden on the bus. They would go on some tours during training camp and preseason, and Madden's people checked in with Roger Goodell's assistant. They said, what would the commissioner like to eat on the bus? And the answer was, well, Roger usually has salad and salmon for lunch. And John Madden's response, we don't have salad or salmon on the Madden Cruiser. Ever.
That's great. I love it. That's right, man. You got to eat. You're on the bus. Enjoy it.
It's football, baby. No salad, no salmon.
Hey, Trenton. 120.
Colts back to work from the 25-yard line. Here's Taylor for a gain of four. Jonathan, you talked about the Colts' slow start, 0-3. We asked their head coach, Frank Reich, about the early portion of the season, and he told us when the running game went from good to great, that's when things turned around.
Yes, and I briefly mentioned the pass game getting incorporated into the run game, and it's because he absolutely needs for Jonathan Taylor, offensive line, to get 4 yards a pop, 5 yards a pop. That's when you start to see all this misdirection from the offense, and then you can get Michael Pittman involved down the field.
Second down and six. Here's Taylor again. Speaking first down and four. Jonathan Taylor out to the 47-yard line, gain of 18.
Man, Jonathan Taylor wastes no time. As soon as we start talking about it, he's going to wait the patience and just explodes through the hole. Trayvon Moehrig, he does not realize how good Jonathan Taylor is. He's got to be that cleanup safety guy, can't get to the tackle. And I really, really like Jonathan Taylor, man. I've been talking about him since his Wisconsin days.
Yes, you have.
And I swear, he's just getting better and better.
From the 47, it's Taylor again across midfield, cuts to the outside, and picks up another first down. Down the sideline, Taylor inside the Raiders 30 to the Las Vegas 29. This time, Jonathan, 24 yards.
Look at that. The jump cut, the vision, the stiff arm, the second stiff arm. Everything you want in a running back. And it's amazing because we never say he's overly big, he's overly fast. He just does everything great.
42 yards on the last two carries. Why not go right back to Taylor? Headed to his first Pro Bowl. We spoke to him this week. told us he loved watching Pro Bowl backs such as Adrian Peterson and Marshawn Lynch and dreamed about reaching their level.
And he has, right? And you see how he started the season 0-3, only 57 rush yards. We called two of those games and we said, get him the ball more. Sure enough, Frank Wright hurt us. Heard probably all the fans in Indy, and you see what's happened since. 139, almost 140 yards a game.
Leads the league in rush yards, rushing touchdowns, scrimmage yards, total touchdowns, and he is closing in on the franchise record for rushing yards in a season. On the toss, it's Hines, and Hines stays on his feet, but there is a flag.
Holding. Offense, number 69, 10-yard penalty, second down.
That's on the left tackle, Pryor.
And that's right in the middle on Yannick and Dockway. That's an easy call for the officials. For, excuse, look like Matt Pryor.
First penalty of the game. Ball spotted back at the 36, second down and 17. Wentz throws over the middle, it's complete. That's the first completion for Carson Wentz this afternoon. Michael Pittman Jr., the Colts' leading receiver, his 77th of the season.
And it makes it so much easier for the passing game. And Carson Wentz, there's Michael Pittman. He and Wentz have really hooked up, have done a really good job. And it goes back to that time on task. Wentz did not have training camp. They've been really getting together after practice, in film. Obviously, the reps that you get through practice and now in the games, it's really starting to show up, he and Michael Pittman.
Third down and 9. Wentz under pressure, stays on his feet, and then the throw out of bounds in the vicinity of Mo Alley Cox. Merrick with the pressure on Wentz.
Nice pressure right up the gut. Trayvon Merrick going up the gut there, and you can see they dialed that one up. That was a Colts-specific blitz. They timed the protection and the snap. Did everything but get the sack, still forces the incompletion.
So here's Michael Badgley, 46 yard attempt. Season long is 45. From the right hash, new long snapper today, Kyle Nelson. Badgley from 46, Colts are on the board. 7-point Raiders lead. Second quarter in Indianapolis.
The best in Canton are never smiling, not even Peyton Manning's. And he's always enjoying himself in real life. So for someone we've enjoyed watching on and off the field, we made him a second bust, one that enshrines his love of life. Behold. The Michelob Ultra Smiling Peyton Bus Tap Handle. Congrats, Peyton.
You probably think Visa is a credit card company, huh? But it's actually a network. Connecting just about everyone to just about everyone else. It can open eyes with a cup of coffee and change minds about what makes a business. And it is working to connect everyone, everywhere. So, meet Visa, a network working for everyone.
History is filled with almosts. Those who almost adventured, who almost achieved. Then, there are others. The ones who embrace the moment and commit. They calm their minds and steel their nerves with four simple words whispered since the time of the Romans. Fortune favors the brave.
Ch-
Joe Millionaire returns with a twist.
Two Joes are better than one.
Who is Joe?
One is a multimillionaire. One is not.
It's not about money. It's about love.
What?
Joe Millionaire premieres this Thursday on Fox.
We continue to pay tribute to the life of Hall of Fame coach and broadcaster John Madden, our former colleague at Fox Sports, who leaves a legacy that will never be forgotten. Coach of the Oakland Raiders for 10 seasons, led the Silver and Black to a Super Bowl championship in 1977 before embarking on a career in the broadcast booth that will never be matched. And of course, to the younger generation of video game enthusiasts, he was just Madden. In fact, he said on numerous occasions, those who remembered him from his Raiders days would call him Coach. Those who knew him as a broadcaster would refer to him as John. And the youngsters would simply call him Madden.
Good. So I fall in the youngsters category. Good. Good. All right. I just wanted to make sure that I'm still a young guy. What'd you refer to him as? Coach? That means you're super old.
That's a great question. He was a youngster when he was hired to coach the Raiders at the age of 32. There's Johnson on the return. Tyron Johnson out across the 35. 10 seasons as Raiders head coach. 7 AFC or AFL title games, 7 division titles. Retired at the age of 42, winning as head coach, and he still is in franchise history. How about that group, Ben? The winning percentage just under 76%.
Look at the group that he leads. Not that he's in, that he leads. That is a special, special group.
We're good, we're good.
Yeah.
Josh Jacobs has returned, so that is good news for the Raiders. Carr complete. It's Jacobs. But he's met immediately by Okereke after a gain of 3. Raiders 12 plays, 75 yards on their opening possession. And then a field goal here in the second quarter, leading the Colts 10-3.
Here's Derek Carr. One of the smartest players that you're going to find in the game.
There's Jacobs on 2nd and 6. Derek Carr telling us the other day, Jonathan, his uncle Lon Boyette was once cut from the team by John Madden. He got to a fight in training camp. Coach Madden came over to try and break it up. He slipped in the mud. And Derek Carr's uncle Lon always thought that was why he was released.
It's exactly why he got released. John Madden, you can't show him up by starting a fight, have him slip, everyone laughing at him. That's definite. All right, here are your papers. Get up out of there.
Third down and 5. Carr under pressure, rolling right. And then Carr throws back across, and it's nearly picked off. A diving attempt made by Rock Yassin. Raiders will punt it away.
This is great defense all around, but you'll see the pressure up front. Coming around the corner, Al-Qadim Muhammad, then they start pressuring him as he flushes the pocket, and that was an ill-advised throw by Derek Carr. Rock Yassin almost comes up with an amazing interception, but he knows you cannot throw across your body like that on the move.
A.J. Cole punting for the first time. He leads the NFL in punt average, heading to the Pro Bowl, and he pins the Colts deep with 8.5 remaining in the second quarter. In Indianapolis, ball will be spotted at the 16-yard line. Colts offense back out onto the field.
We took the truck that helped build this country and made it so it can power our homes. We took the vehicles businesses use to keep the lights on and made them run on the same thing that turns the lights on. We took the original 0 to 60 head turner and gave it zero tailpipe emissions. We took the familiar and made it revolutionary.
I'm dramatically holding this bottle so the light hits it just right and people think, wow, he knows what he's doing, when I'm actually pretty lost with my payroll taxes.
Intuit QuickBooks helps you manage your payroll taxes.
Cheers.
100% accurate payroll tax calculations guaranteed.
My two favorites.
Looks like you already chose your favorite.
Nice. Two favorites.
I'm gonna take this now.
Enjoy any two classics for $6, like the quarter pounder with cheese and 10-piece McNuggets for a limited time at McDonald's.
It's amazing. He's talking about motorcycle insurance, and people love it. Of course, they love the savings they're going to get with Geico, but it goes beyond that.
You deserve to save.
Heard that before.
You deserve to save.
I know.
I need you to hear me. You deserve to save.
I deserve to save.
I mean, he has a way of making you feel seen.
Bundle car and motorcycle insurance and save at geico.com.
The pressure is going to get insane.
The most astounding, captivating, thrilling musical guessing game is back.
She is a bad singer.
The only show where spotting terrible talent can make you really rich.
I Can See Your Voice premieres this Wednesday on Fox.
Today's game is sponsored by Geico. Save even more when you bundle home and car insurance. And by Verizon, the official 5G network of the NFL. Verizon.
Welcome back. Raiders leading the Colts 10-3. For the first time, NFL teams will play 17 games. It's week 18. Coming up next weekend, matchups will be determined following this weekend's games. One last shot to change the playoff picture. The season finale next weekend. So now you have an extra wild card team in each conference once again and a 17th game.
You know, I would love to see. I'll finish it after this play.
From the 16, first down, Jonathan Taylor, back to Jonathan Vilma.
What we should do, Kenny, I would love to see who would make the playoffs after this game, week 17, and then who loses
out next week.
Exactly. You see that playoff picture. I mean, what's amazing to me is that you have over 500. That's just good football. When you think about the parity within the NFL, how hard it is to get to that position, and that's why you got to give your hats off to both head coaches we just saw. To be able to claw their way back to this position, man, that's just phenomenal.
Patriots leading the Jaguars 21-3. Dolphins trailing the Tennessee Titans. Kansas City 21-7 over the Bengals. Midway through the second quarter with the Raiders leading by 7. Here are the teams that made the postseason after an 0-3 start.
And Frank Reich and the Colts, they look like they're going to be a part of this list. If they don't lose, if they don't win today, they still have an opportunity next week.
In with a win today.
In with a win.
Third down and 9. Colts must get to the 26 for a first down. As Wentz throws, catch is made by the tight end, Mole Alley Cox, and he looks to have enough yardage.
Yeah, looks like he got just enough.
There is a flag, however.
Mole Alley Cox working on Desmond Trufant, uses that big tight end body.
Illegal formation, offense, number 72, got up on the line of scrimmage, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Right tackle, Braden Smith.
Braden Smith, what they're talking about, he is backed up too far on the line of scrimmage. So, yeah, we know it's a pass, and they'll give you a little leeway, but you can't be that far back. When you're that far back, the officials have to call it. That was a correct call.
So instead of a first down, Colts now face third and 14. Wentz throws a bit high off the hands of Zach Pascal. Colts sent out the punting unit. We head for a game break. Carissa.
Thanks, Kenny. Bucks Jets tied at 7. Zach Wilson connects with Braxton Berrios for his 9-yard score. Berrios second of the day already. Bucks would add a field goal, but Jets up on the Bucks 14-10. Kenny?
All right, thanks, Carissa. Sanchez setting up in his end zone. Renfro had the 41-yard return earlier. Longest of his career.
The Raiders can be looking at really good field position.
And they will have excellent field position with a 7-point lead here in Indianapolis. Just through the hands of Pascal.
Yes.
What happens when you block heartburn with one Prilosec OTC in the morning? Heartburn doesn't stand a chance. Day or night. Excess stomach acid can cause heartburn. Prilosec OTC works differently by preventing excess acid production. So don't fight heartburn. Block it. Prilosec OTC. One pill in the morning blocks heartburn all day and all night.
When you shop at Target, you leave with what you value most, like healthy foods and brands that lift our communities. At Target, the things that matter are always within reach. What we value most shouldn't cost more.
Woo! Papa John's just took their fresh, never frozen dough and hand stretched it New York style. So you can fold it or not. I ain't gonna lie though, I fold it. Get a New York style pizza from Papa John's.
We are the first family of country music. I gotta show the world the legacy will continue beyond me.
This is about more than cash and contracts.
Her family's all secrets and lies.
What did you do?
If there's a hell, I booked my ticket years ago.
Just watch.
Monarch premieres January 30th on Fox.
Colts fans hoping to celebrate later today. Raiders and Josh Jacobs have other ideas.
Yeah, Josh Jacobs, I mentioned him with a really, really good jump cut, the explosion that he has. See, he makes a guy miss there. Almost made another safety miss on that one, and that touchdown just wasn't fair for Isaiah Rodgers. As soon as he gets north and south, that's an easy touchdown. And that's why I said Josh Jacobs will be sorely missed if he can't go, if he's not 100%.
12 plays, 75-yard drive early, but Colts defense since then with an interception. They held the Raiders to a field goal. They had the short field and then forced a three and out.
That's right, and as we see Josh Jacobs, remember, he also has some rib injury he's dealing with, which might have slowed him down in this Raiders offense.
Raiders start from the 43. Carr with time, fires downfield, and it's caught by Jones for a Raiders first down at the Colts 31-yard line, a 26-yard connection.
Yeah, Derek Carr is going to get the ball down the field, and Zay Jones does a tremendous job of really tightening up his route. Instead of rounding that off, it's a sharp 90 he gets across the field. They waited for the safety Odom to go with Bryan Edwards to the other side, and in comes Zay Jones right where that safety left off for the completion.
Carr has completed 9 of 11 with the one pick.
Susan!
From the Colts 31, it's Jones, and he will lose some yardage.
Yeah. I would much rather see Zay Jones catch deep balls.
Yes.
He looked like you trying to run that fly sweep, didn't he? When you had your sweet cleats on.
Absolutely. It was Kenny Moore who made the play.
Yeah, sweet feet Kenny. And there's offensive coordinator Greg Olson.
Second down at 11. Here's Jacobs. The third and long coming up for the Las Vegas Raiders as we hit 5 minutes remaining in the second quarter here in Indianapolis.
Yeah, that was Bobby Okereke, Darius Leonard. They've been very active in this run game. He's starting longs. finally getting the crowd into it. These third and longs, this is what they live for.
Penalty marker prior to the snap.
False start. Offense. Number 87. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Cross the Moreau. That's the Raiders' first penalty today. Coming into this weekend, they're the most penalized team in the league.
Yeah, and that's the surest way to lose a game. But they've done a great job.
Watch 87, Moreau. Little shift.
Who was he pointing at afterwards?
You.
Probably.
Third down and 13. Carr moving to his left. Throws. It's caught. And Renfro looking to dive forward for the first down. Looks to be just short.
And that was a great effort by Renfro. Officials calling it fourth down. No hesitation. Head coach Rich Bisaccia bringing in the big guys in. Josh Jacobs is coming back in.
Marcus Mariota on the field.
Marcus Mariota, last time he was in, it was a run pass option, a zone read.
This time, Mariota split out to the left.
Oh, there it is.
Shifts into the backfield, and he will take the snap. Mariota picks up a Raiders first down and celebrates.
Nice design all the way through, and then Marcus Mariota talked about Jonathan Taylor's patience. Look at how smooth and calm he is. Follows those big guys. Runs right up the gut for those 2 yards to get the first down. Yeah, you think that they don't want it? Look at that. This is the backup quarterback screaming and celebrating. That's how badly they want to win this game. The intensity is there, man.
Here we go. He's made a couple of key plays here in the first half. New set of downs for the Raiders from the Colts. 19, here's Jacobs. Broke a couple of tackles. And is finally taken down after a gain of 5 at the Colts 14-yard line.
Yeah, and that's the difference with Jacobs in the game. Peyton Barber, he just can't do that, right? Jacobs can press the hole, nothing there, jump cut to the outside, have guys hanging off of him and still gain 4 or 5 yards. And that's so important, especially for Carr, because once they now get down to third down, third and medium, he has so many more options.
2-minute warning in Indianapolis. Both teams control their own destiny. Raiders looking to add to their lead.
We don't follow the herd. Never have, never will. Because those who build the future aren't found in a pack. They forge the way forward on a path of their own. And just when you think the dust has settled, we're here to kick it right back up again. The all-new, all-electric 2021 Mustang Mach-E is here.
Now, only one movie will give theater audiences something to shout about.
Come on.
The King's Man, rated R, now playing only in theaters.
If Mark, Mr. Cartoon Machado, didn't have the fighting spirit to draw out his passion, he never would have turned chrome into a canvas. If he let a lack of tools stop him, he never would have started tattooing using a homemade machine. And if he listened to those who said you need an art degree, he never would have perfected the street look that made him a street legend. That's the fighting spirit. That's what makes a lion. Modelo, root for those with a fighting spirit.
Bridgestone is the official tire sponsor of the NFL, and we're proud to support the Boys and Girls Clubs of America year-round, including a $50,000 pledge made together with Titan University in Nashville. We're committed to helping drive great futures to ensure that every child has an equal opportunity to be prepared to perform. because that's what really matters. To learn more about Bridgestone's efforts to create a more sustainable and inclusive society, visit BridgestoneAmericas.com.
Rise at halftime coming up. Kurt, Terry, and Michael. We'll keep you posted on the playoff picture in both the NFC and the AFC. Bills looking to lock up a spot. And an NFC East wild card showdown. Here in Indy, Kenny Albert, Jonathan Vilma, Sarah Walsh, Darius Leonard getting the crowd fired up. With the Raiders leading by 7. Carr on the sideline. Mariota back in.
I wouldn't be surprised they start to do a pass off of this run pass option. Let Mariota throw one.
We've seen a couple of runs for Mariota so far. Here's Mariota inside the 10.
Fumble.
As a Raiders first down. See where they spot it.
Looking.
Might be just short.
Look at that's Mr. Turnover himself. Darius Leonard comes in with a huge tomahawk chop right on the football. Look at that. I love he goes for that tomahawk chop, then the tackle on the quarterback. And man, they almost recovered it.
They're first. It's a 30-second timeout. Game clock operator, please put 1 minute and 55 seconds on the game clock, please. 1:55. Thank you.
And now this from Progressive.
Progressive presents At Home with Baker Mayfield.
Really appreciate you stepping into house sit. Everything should be pretty straightforward. Here's the keys. Let me show you inside.
So each heater's on its own power grid, so you're just going to have to throw the breakers each night.
Tuesday's trash day. Just pull the dumpsters out the night before. Do you like dogs?
There are dogs.
It's a whole section of them. If you're gonna leave, remember to set the alarm. The code is 6.
Just 6?
Shh.
Just under 2 minutes remaining. Second quarter. Third down and 1 for the Las Vegas Raiders. Mariota remains in. Penalty marker.
Yeah, Alex Leatherwood couldn't hold his water.
False start. Offense. Number 70. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
And there is Alex.
Ooh. Got to hold in there. Hold just a little bit.
Oh, Derek Carr comes back in. Mariota on the sideline. I promise you, that's the first option.
Third down and 6. Carr sacked. It's Quiddy Pay again.
Tremendous job up front. Everyone is coming and it's almost like a meet you at the quarterback, DeForest Buckner, Quiddy Pay. They love, absolutely love this rookie, Quiddy Pay. They think he's going to be something special.
First round pick out of Michigan.
See how quickly this game can change. They had 3rd and inches. All of a sudden, you get a false start, brings you back to 3rd and 5, get the sack. Now you're looking at this long field goal. Man, the momentum. That's why I love these games, man. The momentum can switch just like that.
44-yard attempt. Carlson hit from 47 earlier. He is now 2 for 2. Raiders back up by 10 here at Indy.
Some of my best memories growing up were cooking with Mom. She always said, food is love. So when she moved in with us, a new kitchen became part of our financial plan.
There was a dream.
I want to make the most of every meal we have together.
At Northwestern Mutual, our version of financial planning helps you live your dreams today. Find a Northwestern Mutual advisor at nm.com.
Bend those knees.
Today, business is a balancing act. You want your data to be protected and secured. And your customers want seamless and easy. With IBM, you can do both. Your company can monitor threats across your clouds, address all those regulations, and still create all new experiences. Trustworthy AI-powered security. That's why so many businesses work with IBM.
Fox Tonight. Experience the most extraordinary.
I'm about to pass out!
Most challenging.
I hope you came to compete.
Most revolutionary cooking competition ever.
Oh, no!
It's Gordon Ramsay like you've never seen him before.
We're not just going to give out $250,000. You got to earn it.
When the contestants face off and the chef mentors go to war.
You guys have gone for, trust me.
I got the squad.
I've got my winner.
Next Level Chef, series premiere tonight on Fox.
This has been the game plan all year. And it got us to the playoffs. Why change now?
The entire NFL mourning the loss of the great Dan Reeves, longtime player, head coach, passed away yesterday at the age of 77. There he is with the Dirty Birds, the Atlanta Falcons. Terrific man.
Really was all football, all the time. We talked about John Madden and the impact he had. Dan Reeves, in similar respect, had a lot of impact. Think about it. When you talk about nine trips to the Super Bowl, come on. I mean, it's no better than that.
Playing for the Cowboys in the Ice Bowl, he threw a 50-yard touchdown pass.
Wow.
December 31st, 1967.
I'm really saying wow because he was in the Ice Bowl. Everything about that just sounds cold, terrible.
How would you have done that day?
I wouldn't have come out. Just call it, coach.
Kickoff out of bounds. This will give the Colts excellent field position at the 40.
Free kick out of bounds. Number two, kicking team. Ball's placed at the 40-yard line. First down.
What's coming up at halftime? Kurt Benefit.
TV, what are you doing?
Just keeping track of my New Year's resolutions.
Give me one.
Watch more Verizon halftime shows.
You're in luck. We've got the Verizon halftime coming up.
Wow, you know what that means? Whatever I write down happens. Win the lotto!
My pretty!
We'll see you at halftime.
Terry the big winner, perhaps?
No. Can you imagine John Madden coached against him? That's how old he is.
In many big games.
Yes.
Tremendous battles. Colts with one timeout. They start from the 40, trailing by 10. Pass a bit low. It was caught by Hines. It's only the second completion for Wentz. Now remember, the Colts deferred at the start of the game, so they are looking for a 2-for-1.
Yeah, only need about 20 more yards. They'll be in field goal range.
Second down and 5. Wentz fires. Catch is made by the tight end, Mo Ali Cox, in Raiders territory. Gain of 18.
Yeah, they're going quickly, and Gus Bradley, defensive coordinator, he's staying very basic, very soft with the defense.
From the 38, on first down, Pittman takes it to the Las Vegas 31. Under a minute remaining. Gus Bradley, defensive coordinator. Second down and 2. Wentz to the outside. Hines, first down. Out of bounds, stops the clock.
Now that Carson Wentz has kind of slowed it down. I wouldn't be surprised if Gus Bradley brings a 5th rusher or even a 6th, get a real blitz in there. The soft coverage got him down here way too quickly.
Wentz, 3-for-3 on this drive.
Yep. Now look, they have wide receiver on a linebacker.
Pass caught by Jack Pascal.
Yeah, and as good as Denzel Perryman is, he's a Pro Bowler. That's always going to be a tough matchup. I've been there, always looking at that number three, and it's a wide receiver. I already start dreading it, like, oh, here we go.
Second down and two. Wentz to the outside. It's Bo Alley Cox. So Wentz had only one completion prior to this drive. He's now 5 for 5.
Yeah, this has been really soft coverage. And Ali Mo Cox, nice concentration. Mo Alley Cox toe taps, controls the football.
Down to 19 seconds on the clock. New set of downs from the Raiders 13.
Man, this has not been good for the Raiders in the red zone. They are the absolute worst in opponent red zone TD percentage. So if there's ever a time to step up, it's going to be here for the Raiders.
Wentz on first down, throws, caught. Take it to the 1 yard line by Pittman.
And
Colts
Wentz just used
use their final timeout.
Yep.
Remember the out of bounds kickoff? So the Colts started at their 40. Short field, and now they're 1 yard away.
Mm. That was a rocket. Steps right into the throw. Uses that big arm. Extremely accurate. Michael Pittman on the receiving end of that throw.
So now 13 seconds remaining, no timeouts.
And you still have your options to throw to the outside. As I mentioned earlier, red zone defense, absolute worst in TD percentage. People don't get down there a lot, but when they do, they score touchdowns. And 13 seconds, you can still hit those little corner routes. And it's easy for Carson Wentz, right? If I don't see it, I just throw it away, and I'll still have an option to throw a couple more times. Being so close, I would be surprised if they run it, but you still can one play.
You think? With no timeouts?
I would be very surprised if they run it. I see the bunch formation at the bottom of the screen, and I see them working towards that.
On first and goal, Wentz looking end zone.
There it is. Smartly throws it away.
Down to 9 seconds. Ngakoue applied the pressure.
And this is going to be nice coverage on that bunch. They move out of it, and as soon as they do, you see they double the top. Everyone starts to plaster. Wentz smartly throws it away. Now, the clock on TV is showing 13 seconds. That is not correct.
9 seconds on the scoreboard.
That's right. There's only 9 seconds left.
Second and goal. Wentz looking. He throws. Back of the end zone. Oh. Incomplete.
Didn't complete it.
Ashton Doolin, the intended receiver. Down to 4 seconds remaining.
Man, I thought he almost made the most spectacular play of this game. Looked like he would have toe tapped too, had both feet in. Look at the pressure.
Not sure about the second foot. And then
he dropped
the football.
Yeah. Well, he dropped it anyway.
Wentz checking out the replay. Down to 4 seconds. Wentz hands it off, and the Colts into the end zone. Final play of the second quarter. Jonathan Taylor, his 20th touchdown of the season.
Look at the push that offensive line gets. I'm watching three of the Vegas Raiders defensive linemen in the end zone getting pancaked, and Jonathan Taylor just runs right over the safety for the touchdown. What a gutsy call. 4 seconds left, no timeouts. And if there's ever a time that you just saw how much trust Frank Reich has in the offensive line and in Jonathan Taylor to get that score, that was it right there.
Patchley, extra point, good. So Jonathan Taylor, the NFL's leading rusher, most touchdowns in the league. 1 second remaining as the Indianapolis Colts pull to within three, and they will get the ball first in the second half.
I mean, executed perfectly. Started with the kick out of bounds. From there, Carson Wentz went on fire like clockwork. It was a machine going down the field, marched right down there. And, you know, unfortunately, we all kind of knew what was going to happen. The Raiders defensively have not been good in the red zone. Carson Wentz, Jonathan Taylor, offensive line, got to give them the credit to get that touchdown.
They had first and goal with 13 seconds remaining. Tried a couple of passes to the end zone. And then with 4 seconds left, they keep it on the ground and go to Jonathan Taylor, their most valuable player. Johnson, zeros on the clock. First half comes to an end. First half stats brought to you by State Farm. Raiders with that 75-yard drive to open the game. Not much after. They had the ball for 18 and a half minutes. Colts capitalize on their final possession. Pull to within three. Both teams control their own destiny. Colts clinch a playoff spot with a win. Raiders need two or one and a lot of help. Carson Wentz returning after he was in health and safety protocols all week. He was excellent on that final drive of the half. Completed his first 7 pass attempts.
Yeah, it was a really good first half all around, Penny. I like the momentum and the way they fought back.
Raiders lead by 3. Time now for
counts of the game without the consent of NFL Productions is prohibited.
If you're a pro football fan, this is where you want to be today.
See that hole right there? He sees it and knows that he can get all the way to the goal line with it.
Boom! You're talking, and this is football. You can't get up for this. You can't get up for anything.
This has been the sweetest ride of them all. Thank you.
Today's game flow brought to you by Progressive. There's certainly nowhere we would rather be, and what a tremendous job by our production crew.
That was awesome. That was simply awesome.
Steve Malone and company. Getting it done. Both teams control their own destiny. Raiders win their last 2. They are in. Colts clinch a playoff berth with a win today. Neither team can be eliminated following games this weekend. Colts will start at their 25. Kenny Albert along with Jonathan Vilma here in Indianapolis. So we know what's at stake for both teams. Raiders come out, start the game on a 12-play, 75-yard drive. Colts answer at the end of the second quarter.
Yeah, this is reminiscent of a heavyweight match, right? You have a couple blows, they trade them. You have the Vegas Raiders, they come out hot, and then the Colts adjusted. Then the Colts, they finally answered late in the first half, and they adjusted the Vegas Raiders, especially with that run game. So I look to see that the Vegas Raiders are going to continue to stop the run, put a lot of guys in the box on Jonathan Taylor, and then jump off sides like Darius Filan just did.
Offside defense number 96 with contact. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Raiders penalized only twice in the first half. Colts did not know if Carson Wentz would be in uniform until earlier today. The health and safety protocol throughout the week. But he did, in fact, make the start. Colts trail by three on the toss. Jonathan Taylor, first down and much more. Knocked out of bounds at the 45 as we check in with Sarah following a 15-yard run.
Well, Kenny, Frank Reich told me he thought his defense really picked up the tempo after what he said was a slow start on that first drive. As for his offense, while he loved that touchdown to go into the break, he said that they have to be better on third downs. They have to find a way to keep drives alive. On the Raiders side of things, Rich Bisaccia was upset about the kick that put them in poor field position at the end there. So he said his message to the team, they got to come out here and reset, Kenny.
Thanks, Sarah. That kickoff out of bounds set the Colts up at their 40 on that last possession of the first half. Taylor closing in on Edrin James and his franchise record. He gains two and is now 11 yards shy of matching the great Edrin James. Colts in the first half, Jonathan, only 53 yards on their first four drives and then 60 on the last one.
Yeah, we got to give credit to Carson Wentz. He was able to pick apart that Raiders defense on that last drive. It was, again, simply masterful. Had one timeout, marched all the way down the field for the touchdown. And if you wonder why they're so excited to have him, that's why. As smart as Sam Ehlinger is, we had a great dissertation from him on the breakdown of their offense today. You need a guy that's been there and done that.
Second down and eight. Play action. Wentz complete. Mo Alley-Cox. Ball came loose out of bounds. He was close to first down yardage. It will depend on the spot. And he's about a yard shy.
Yeah, this is a good spot by the officials. Third down. Frank Reich brings in Deion Jackson. You're going to see two running backs, Jonathan Taylor and then Deion Jackson. Up at the top of the screen, they like to motion him back. And then you'll see them run the football with Taylor.
Exactly as you described, and instead it's Jackson.
Ooh.
Not Taylor.
Yeah, a little wrinkle to their offense. Did not catch the Raiders off guard.
Jackson, the rookie out of Duke, 13th carry this season. And now on fourth down, Frank Reich leaves his offense out on the field. Yeah, what do you
no
look
hesitation.
For here?
I would look for Jonathan Taylor all day long.
Fourth and one. Instead, it is Wentz. With help from the tight end, Kylan Grayson, number 83. Wentz has a first down.
Yeah, reminiscent of the Bush push. If anyone remembers that Notre Dame, USC game.
Taylor with an assist as well.
Taylor with the assist. Carson Wentz definitely would not have gotten that first down had it not been for his backups there pushing him along.
There's a reason why you guys push those sleds during training camp.
I don't think that's the reason, but I'll take it.
Ron Madden would have loved that play.
5-2, 5-2, 5-2.
Yes, he would have.
From the 45, fake to Taylor. Wentz steps up. Wentz fires downfield. Caught
on
the deflection. T.Y. Hilton, touchdown.
Unbelievable, Kenny. The pressure is coming right up the gut. Max Crosby had a chance, missing. He rolls out, and that's the big arm we talked about. Oh, my goodness. How did they miss that?
The Colts lead for the first time. Wentz, Hilton, 17-13, Indianapolis.
Progressive presents At Home with Baker Mayfield.
I'm happy she's renovating her kitchen, but if I have to hear about subway tile one more time...
I know, right? She acts like she's the first person to ever put it in her home.
hello, 1904.
Thank you. Oh, there she goes. Oh, driving a new car, but couldn't donate to my walkathon.
She's a good egg, though.
You know what she is? She is. Did you hear she's pulling her kids out of tennis?
Stop it. Again?
Local restaurants have been hit hard by fees from delivery apps.
They take a huge chunk of our bottom line. All of that comes out of our pocket and goes to them.
So Domino's franchisees went to local restaurants and bought $100,000 of their gift cards to give out to our customers. That way, they could support a mom and pop by ordering directly from them.
And no one got hit by delivery app fees.
I can't believe one restaurant is buying another restaurant's gift certificates to give out, but it sure is wonderful.
So if you're not getting Domino's, skip the delivery apps and order directly from a local restaurant.
People think unusual circumstances means complicated taxes, but for a TurboTax Live expert like me, it just makes things interesting. So, give us everything you've got.
What if I'm a professional gamer with a ton of expenses?
If they help drive views, let's talk deductions.
What if I'm in a state with no income tax, but my survival videos are viewed in 38 countries?
I can help. And if this is a business dinner, save those jerky receipts. An interesting life can mean an even greater refund. You do your thing. We've got your taxes. Intuit TurboTax Live.
Fox Thursday. One bachelor's rich, the other is poor, but the women won't know who until the very end.
What's a reality show without a few little twists?
Joe Millionaire for Richer or Poorer premieres this Thursday on Fox.
Six plays, 75 yards. What a finish.
What a finish. I can't even sit here and tell you anything other than it's better to be lucky than good sometimes. T.Y. Hilton in the right spot at the right time. Carson Wentz avoided the pressure, just heaves it down there. And look at him like, whoo, yeah. Oh, I love it. And he knows. You can see it on his face. He knows. He got away with one.
Touchdowns for the Colts on back-to-back possessions.
Successfully completed the 2-for-1.
Now Derek Carr, the Raiders offense back out. First drive of the game, 12 plays, 75 yards. Touchdown, not much since.
No, the Colts defense really settled in, and it was frankly just getting off blocks. They started getting off the blocks. The linebackers are being more active. Darius Leonard, Bobby Okereke, they started really getting downhill and forcing the issue, and then the pressure up front, Quiddy Pay, DeForest Buckner, really starting to cause problems for Derek Carr.
Raiders trailing for the first time today. They start from the 25, Carr complete, Jones, and then Kenny Moore comes up to make the tackle.
Right, Kenny, take a listen to this. Kenny Moore, the Pro Bowler. Boom! Right there.
One of the league high 7 Colts selected to the Pro Bowl.
And well deserved, man. Those sweet feet, you just saw it in action. Rarely see him out of position. Rarely ever see him. And every time, it's either pass breakup or someone's getting hit just like that.
Simpson! Second down and 5. Jacobs and Frank Reich certainly enjoyed announcing who the Pro Bowlers would be.
Sometimes you get what you deserve right away, and then sometimes you got to wait a second for it. But I know we're all going to celebrate this. Ooh.
Lightning in the bottom. Yeah!
That's the Colts.com. For the video, Kenny Moore and 6 teammates headed to the Pro Bowl.
That's just great. Lightning in the bottle, matched up against Hunter Renfro in the slot.
Carr on third down, it's complete. Jones makes the catch, his 5th, and picks up a Raiders first down.
And see, they motion in. What they're starting to do is have Bryan Edwards and Hunter Renfro start to be decoys, and it makes it hard for Isaiah Rodgers, who's playing over the top. Well, they start running these underneath routes. So Zay Jones just waits, lets everyone clear out, knowing he just has to run right towards the sticks. Derek Carr will put it on the money for him for the first down.
First and 10, 38-yard line. Jacobs running left. Josh Jacobs out to the 46-yard line. Gain of 8, setting up second down and 2.
This is a little reminiscent of the first drive of the game, where the Raiders came out, the very balanced attack, getting the ball to the outside, the perimeter. There's defensive coordinator Matt Eberflus stresses what he says, HITS, the acronym, HITS.
Come on, come on.
Stands for hustle, intensity, takeaways, and being smart.
We're good, we're good.
Raiders with three tight ends. Peyton Barber in the backfield on second and 2. Here's Barber, and he will pick up a Las Vegas first down out to the 49-yard line.
Yeah, and that's where Barber is at his best. These short yardage situations, let him just wear down and, you know, bowl his way for a first down. They bring back Zay Jones and Brian Edwards. Foster Moreau has been really quiet today. I was expecting for Foster Moreau to have some more production, more action. It's been a little quiet. They need to get him involved.
Only three Raiders with receptions. 5 for Jones. Renfro with 4. Jacobs, the other 3.
Easy, easy. Easy, easy. Hey, A.J. Nyble, New York. A.J. Nyble, New York.
Play clock at 2.
Sims is up.
Raiders took too much time.
Delay a game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Doug Olson, offensive coordinator, as the Raiders are set back 5 yards, now first and 15. Renfro in motion. Had 3 catches on the opening drive, only 1 since. Pass, pass is picked off. Darius Leonard with the second Colts interception this afternoon.
Carson Wentz is still down. Derek Carr is still down after that throw. And that sensational interception by the Colts, Darius Leonard.
Ideas are nothing until we make them real. The big ideas and the challenging ones, even the really good ones, they all take work, passion, perseverance, and the determination to make them better than the ones before. Everything we've ever done is nothing compared to what we imagine for the future. Honda, the power of dreams.
How bizarre. No annual fee on any Discover card.
The BK $5 Your Way meal is here to make your choice easy and so tasty. Go straight to the Double Whopper Jr. with piping hot small fries, 4-piece crispy nuggets, and a refreshing small drink. Can you believe you get all this for only $5? The $5 Your Way meal, only at Burger King.
T'was grace that taught my heart to feel. Through many dangers, toils and snares.
Darius Leonard comes up with his 4th interception of the season, and in the 4 fumbles, 9 takeaways.
The best thing about Darius Leonard has always been his instincts, especially in the pass game. You see him lined up, and then as soon as he starts to realize, all right, this is my pass job, but his instincts take over because he realizes, I'm covering nothing. This is air. Let me get back over here naturally, because that's where Derek Carr is looking. As soon as he does that, catches it like a wide receiver, uses all hands for that interception. That is just beautiful. And then Taylor Stallworth just put a shot on Derek Carr. He was sitting there and literally was just on the knee for a little bit. And see, he started grabbing his elbow, and you see the frustration. That arm may be bothering him, but more importantly, they've got to win this game.
Colts start from their 49. And now Taylor crosses midfield into Raiders territory.
And you see where he's pointing. They're actually trying to hide it. You notice he's down low. Guys are kind of blocking. He doesn't want to show that he's injured or something's wrong. But you can tell. Just look at his face. This is a man that is visibly frustrated right now and in some pain.
Hey, five. Drop it. 5-2, 5-2. Yeah. Green 80.
Second down and six. It's Taylor. A first down and a franchise record for rushing yards in a season.
And he passes Edgerrin James. Sets the record, the patience he has, the explosion, and here it is.
Standing ovation from the crowd.
Well-deserved standing ovation. Look at the guys he passed. Edgerrin James, Eric Dickerson. These are Hall of Famers. So if you want to know how special Jonathan Taylor is, just look at the company that he's leading.
Now, as long as he doesn't lose 3 yards on his next carry.
Oh, don't jinx him like that, Kenny. You're the worst.
Could have set the record twice. Catch made by Pittman.
You're the worst.
The great Eric Dickerson. Edgerrin James. And Jonathan Taylor does not even need game 17 to set the new franchise record.
Yeah, no asterisk by his name. And look at those two guys, man. Edgerrin James, I can't talk enough about what he meant to me as a Hurricanes fan watching him. And he reinvigorated the program. He set the tone. I go there, we won a national championship. And we were here. Fortunately, we had the honor of watching him and Peyton Manning receive their rings at halftime to start the season.
Right, Hall of Fame rings, and I know had a chance to chat with Edgerrin after that game.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And always love talking with him. He just has a different mentality, man. Those, you know, the Hall of Famers, the elite of the elite, they just think differently, act differently. And Edgerrin James, man, he was special. Very, very special.
So Jonathan Taylor breaks the franchise record for rushing yards in the season. His touchdown earlier matches Lenny Moore with 20 TDs. First player under 23 years old with 20 touchdowns and 2,000 scrimmage yards in a season. Incredible.
And still wants to improve. He was a pleasure to talk to.
Third down and six. Wentz can't find anyone. There is a flag. And Gakwe brings him down.
It looks like it's going to be holding on Ryan Kelly, Pro Bowl center.
Holding, offense, number 78. The penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Yeah, coming right at you, fans. That's an easy call for the officials. And Gakwe leading the Raiders with 9 sacks. Super athletic. Very, very fluid in his hips. Can turn the corner. He's doing all he can to keep this Raiders defense and keep this Raiders team in this game.
So a huge play, taking the Colts out of field goal range. Unable to capitalize on the excellent starting field position. Renfro deep. Sanchez from his 46. Renfro lets it go, and what a play on special teams Ashton Doolin hustling downfield to pin Derek Carr and the Raiders deep. Playoff type atmosphere here in Indianapolis.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
It is all about T-Mobile with their great phone deals for everyone every day, including customers on Sprint. Tell us more, Diane.
New and existing customers on the Magenta Max plan can trade up to the new iPhone 13 Pro, and T-Mobile will pay for it. Customers can also get a free year of Apple TV Plus. I know you love Ted Lasso, George.
Guilty as charged. T-Mobile is bringing it all together for the holidays.
Upgrade to the iPhone 13 Pro on us. Plus, get a free year of Apple TV Plus only at T-Mobile.
You don't come to Vegas for one game, one race, one fight, one matchup, or one team. You come for the epic pregame and 3 days of postgame. You come for the showtime and go time and 24 hours of prime time. Because the game is just the beginning. Las Vegas, the greatest arena on earth.
I gotta know who oven baked my bacon. Who did it? Tyler. Come on over here, man.
Oh. Oh. Wow. Ow.
Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
What's the fallout from WWE Day 1 and what's next for the Universal Champion Roman Reigns? Find out on the first SmackDown of the new year. Live this Friday at 8 Eastern on Fox.
Colts lead by four. The NFL's Inspire Change initiative focuses on reducing barriers to opportunity and creating progress in education, economic advancement, community and police relations, and criminal justice reform. Text NFLIC to 635-635 to learn more. Sarah.
And along those lines, Kenny, the Colts and DeForest Buckner have partnered with Big Brothers Big Sisters of Central Indiana. The Colts recently donated $150,000 to the organization, which Buckner has been involved with mentoring youth since he came to the Colts. Buckner told me it's important to show the younger generation how to treat people. And he said he loves that organization because he says mentoring kids at a young age really, truly has a long-term effect, Kenny.
All right, thanks, Sarah. Great job by DeForest Buckner and the entire Colts organization.
Yes, I love that DeForest Buckner, his thought process is long-term, not the immediate, just give your dollar and I did my part. He really wants to inspire change.
Derek Carr injured after throwing that interception, remains in, handing it off to Peyton Barber, who gains a couple.
Well, Peyton Barber is in, Josh Jacobs is on the sideline. And he does not look like he's coming back in yet. But you have DeSean Jackson, Zay Jones, and there's Josh Jacobs still on the sideline. You see him start messing around with those ribs. Like I said, for a running back, yeah, he has a rib protector there, but I mean, he's going to take a shot, get tackled around there, and I know it's painful.
We missed some time earlier in this game. Second down and 8. Carr throws complete. First catch of the day for DeSean Jackson. And we head to Los Angeles for a game break. Carissa.
Thanks, Kenny. We got a wild one in Cincy. Bengals down by 11. Joe Burrow links up again with Ja'Marr Chase. His third of the day. Bengals trail by 4. Okay.
Well, thanks, Carissa. Cincinnati with the opportunity to clinch the division with a win today. Down by 4. Colts clinch with a win as well. Clinch a playoff berth. Third down and 3 for Carr and the Raiders. Pass underneath. Caught by Richard, and he breaks free. A first down and much more as number 30 takes it out to the 30, a 19-yard catch and run.
Derek Carr feeling the pressure. As soon as he starts feeling the pressure coming from the left side, he's going to step up, find that check down. And then a rare missed tackle by Darius Leonard. Had you tackled him right there, it would have been fourth and short. Instead, you got a nice breakaway from Darius Leonard. And now you see Marcus Mariota lined up in the backfield as a quarterback.
Derek Carr, top of your screen. Jacobs back on the field as well. Mariota throws and Renfrow unable to come up with it. No flags with Rhodes defending.
Renfrow's on the inside, going to run an over route for Mariota. Of course, Derek Carr is going to stay right there. This is a two-man route. And you see they're trying to occupy the safeties as they do get one-on-one coverage. Xavier Rhodes up to the challenge on Hunter Renfro. Nice defense, nice pass breakup.
Mariota did not have a pass attempt this season coming into the game. Second and 10. Carr takes the snap. Carr to the outside, caught for a first down. Zay Jones, his sixth reception today, gain of 13.
Yeah, I was actually surprised that they used Mariota to throw that ball in that situation. He had usually been coming in on short yardage or down the goal line, red zone area. That's when you surprise him with the pass. They decided to take their shot there with Mariota. Instead, Derek Carr now comes back, having a lot of success throwing those out routes, out breaking routes to DeSean Jackson and Zay Jones.
From the 43 on first down, Carr's pass incomplete in the vicinity of Jones.
Yeah, he had Zay Jones. It looks like he expected him to just stop or sit in that zone, and Xavier Rhodes just went down. He's grabbing, looks like his hamstring. He was the player with that great defense on Hunter Renfro. We'll be back.
On the season finale of Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
Another season almost in the books.
Yep. It's gonna be a long off season.
Off season?
What do we do in the off season?
Off season?
Relax. We don't stop existing when the season ends.
Yeah, it's not like we live in some fictional town that's part of some elaborate marketing campaign.
What would it even be for? Dr. Pepper?
We're real people. It's not like we're the ice cold Dr. Pepper guy.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
I'm those fries you've been craving. I'm hot, and I'm steamy, and oh man, do I smell delicious. I'm calling your name. Oh, Doug. Doug.
And if you don't have the right auto insurance coverage, paying for these repairs may be tough to swallow.
Get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem for a whole lot less.
The KFC chicken sandwich is only served one way. Straight from the fryer, piping hot, and Kentucky Fried to order. If you don't like it this way, you'll have to go somewhere else. KFC, it's finger-licking good.
We all need help. Just different kinds. Maybe you need a little. Maybe you need a lot. At H&R Block, get the expert tax help you need, online and in person. Help is here.
This is Next Level Chef.
These chefs will have to compete at every level.
This is not next level cooking.
It was brutal.
Oh my goodness me.
Next Level Chef premieres tonight on Fox.
And Xavier Rhodes, you see him wincing on the sideline. You're watching at the top of the screen, top right of the screen. He's running with DeSean Jackson, and it doesn't look like much. As soon as he gets going, that's where you feel the grab, and that was it, man. He went down. And he is now, as soon as he tried to stretch it out, realized, nope, can't do it. And those hamstring injuries, they are the worst. As soon as you try to bend or something happens, they just starts to grab at you and pull at you. And for a corner, especially him, his size, his speed, it's going to be tough to see him back unless they really work on that hamstring.
Replaced by Isaiah Rogers.
Yeah, we're good, we're good.
Second and 10 for Derek Carr and the Raiders.
Susan.
Jacobs. Jacobs across midfield. There is a flag.
And then Jacobs stays down.
This play is coming back.
Yeah, he's not even going to try to get back out there.
During the run, block in the back. Offense number 17. 10-yard penalty, second down.
Tyron Johnson
Tyron Johnson's going to come from the right side of the screen. Can't do it. Can't do it. That's as clear as day.
Fifth Raiders penalty. Second down and 20 with Barber in the backfield. Carr's pass complete. It's Barber out to the 40.
And Ken, here's the defense. After that first series, it's been lights out for the Colts defense. Got the interception, got the pressure, the coverage has been there. Almost had the interception by Rocket Sin, and then you have that combination of both coverage, plastering your guys, Quiddy Pay, DeForest Buckner getting after it. Now, Derek Carr has seen a whole lot today, and this Colts defense has been dialed in since that first series.
Final minute, third quarter, third down and 14. Carr over the middle, incomplete. Brian Edwards, the antenna receiver, Raiders will punt it away.
Yeah, we just said, plaster coverage. Where do you want Derek Carr to throw the football? He's holding on, third and long. And that's just great coverage. Yeah, arm is wrapped around the hip. He does not pull him, doesn't yank him, goes right inside and gets the pass breakup. And, yep, I hear you, Rock. I hear you, my man.
Rock, you've seen. Makes the play on third down. Hines back deep. Punt into the end zone. Here's a word from Michael Cole, the voice of the WWE on Fox.
What's the fallout from WWE Day 1? And what's next for the Universal Champion Roman Reigns? Find out on the first SmackDown of the new year. It's an all-new Friday Night SmackDown, live this Friday at 8 Eastern, 7 Central on Fox. Are
you ready, you ready, Jonathan?
I'm always ready. I'm not as ready as they are, but I'm ready, though. Remember, we would go down... When the Raiders were in Oakland, we go and play over there. Those fans, you talk about crazy. They would get up for it. It was like Halloween times 20, seeing those fans screaming and yelling. Man, those were some good times, good times. Though the Vegas fans, they've been good too now.
They traveled well this weekend. Catch made by Pittman. Gains a couple out to the 22-yard line. Hayward the tackle as... Time winds down in this third quarter. Raiders led 10-0, 13-3. But the Colts with touchdowns on back-to-back possessions. End of the second quarter, and then to start the third, Indianapolis can clinch a playoff berth with a win today. They lead the Raiders by 4. Colts do not have to run a play before the... Time runs all the way down here in the third.
And Casey Hayward, Carson Wentz. Having a nice little chat. You see right there, T.Y. Hilton got that touchdown. The intensity has been there all game long, and we'll be back. Only way for the Colts to win the AFC South is the Titans lose out and the Colts win out. So if the Titans are winning, if they win that game, they will be the AFC South champions. Second year in a row. And the Colts, if they win today, they'll clinch a playoff berth. Look, from where they started to where they are now, I'm sure they would take that.
Start of the season 0-3. Titans clinch the division with a win or a Colts loss.
Navy, Justin.
Carson Wentz saw that they were going to blitz from the top of the screen.
Second down and 8. Here they come. Wentz wrapped up, able to get rid of it, pass incomplete.
The pressure, you're talking about Nate Hobbs. He was coming in from the top of the screen, and you see Darius Filon. He's getting in there. Malcolm Kuntz is getting in as well. The difference was the Raiders played man behind that rush as opposed to zone. They usually like to play zone behind those five-man pressures. They played man defense. messed up Carson Wentz just a little bit. We see Malcolm Kuntz right there, got the pressure leading to this third down.
Third down and 8. Colts must get to the 30. And they will not pass out of the reach of T.Y. Hilton.
Oh my God, Carson Wentz, how do you miss a wide open T.Y. Hilton? Just over the outstretched arms of T.Y., the busted coverage by the Raiders. You hadn't seen it all game long. And Carson Wentz, yes, that is when you make them pay. Man, T.Y. Hilton, as fast as he is, nobody was catching him. That was a house call.
Sanchez punting from his 10. Renfro under it. Had the big return earlier, 41 yards. And this will set up good field position for Las Vegas. Now this from State Farm.
Jay from State Farm, we got to talk.
Yeah, it turns out you guys give everyone great rates.
I'm aware.
Well, then how come this entire time we've been calling it the Patrick price?
I've literally never called it that.
Yeah, you call it the Rogers rate, which is cool. But it's a pretty inaccurate name when Stevie gets it, too.
We offer great rates to fit anyone's budget.
You should just say that next time.
First time.
Fit any budget, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs continue to lead the Bengals by 4. Kansas City has already clinched the division. They would clinch the number one seed with a win and a Tennessee loss. Titans continue to lead the Dolphins 17-3. Colts leading the Raiders here 17-13. Las Vegas back to work from their 38-yard line. On first down, it's Jacobs. Not much, Sarah.
Kenny, we saw Xavier Rhodes gingerly leave the field. That is a hamstring. They brought him over to the bench. They iced it. He is officially ruled as out. And I can tell you, I mean, he couldn't even walk over here. He needed help to move down from his seat on the bench. So we won't see him again, unfortunately, today, Kenny.
All right, thanks very much, Sarah. So Isaiah Rogers on the field in Rhodes' spot.
Yeah, Xavier Rhodes was a tremendous pickup from the Minnesota Vikings. He had some really, really good years, and the frustration setting in. Hopefully they'll have him back in time for the playoffs.
Second down and 9. Carr fires downfield. Zay Jones makes the catch. Inside the Colts' 20-yard line. 42-yard pass play.
Nice job, Xavier Jones, literally just running away from the secondary. You're going to see as soon as he stems up, he just goes, and he's now running away from George Odom. Nice pass by Derek Carr, putting it on the money. You see his eyes light up as soon as he sees it. He's like, oh, I got him. Beautiful ball. Setting up the Raiders. Now Mariota, he's back in.
Mariota hands it off. Jacobs brought down by Muhammad. Fifth-year receiver Zay Jones, first 100-yard game of his career.
Wow, really? That's the trust that Derek Carr has in him. Zay Jones right now on the sideline, but huge contribution in this drive. And we know how many times Derek Carr, that offense, they get those big plays, and he's been a big part of it.
Jacobs out, Barber in. Second down and 9. Carr, Barber. Cut down by Rogers.
As the Raiders quickly get to third down. Zay Jones is coming back in. I would imagine another bunch formation. Bunch of those wide receivers make it hard for the Colts secondary to play press man. And of course, Hunter Renfro. This is the smartest thing that they've done, having Hunter Renfro stay right next to Derek Carr so they can't press him. He can run his option routes from the field, from the backfield.
Third down and 7. It's Renfro, but not enough. Needed to get to the 9-yard line. Kenny Moore makes the tackle.
Yeah, see, this is always a great play, except when you have a Pro Bowler and Kenny Moore who's watching him. One-on-one coverage, this is why it makes a Pro Bowl.
What do you think about this? Fourth down, Rich Bisaccia down by four, leaves the offense on the field.
I don't like it. I would take the points, kick the field goal. You'd be down by one. You have plenty of time to get another stop defensively.
Carr on fourth and two, rolling right, throws to the end zone. Touchdown, Renfro. But there is a flag.
Looks like it's going to be holding on the defense.
Holding defense, number 23. Penalty is declined. Result of the play, touchdown.
So Rich Bisaccia's decision pays off for the Las Vegas Raiders.
And Kenny Moore, he's locked up against Hunter Renfro like he's been all game long. Here's the difference, time. See, he was locked up, did not expect Renfro to bend right back inside. It's a great playoff of what they've usually been doing all game long. He bends inside, he wasn't ready for it. That's a nice touchdown by the Vegas Raiders.
Gutsy decision by Rich Bisaccia.
Yeah, only gutsy because it worked. If it didn't work, it was a poor decision.
Exactly.
Either way.
Raiders back on top, lead the Colts by three.
It's a most unusual day. Feel like throwing my worries away. As an old native-born Californian would say, it's a most unusual day. It's a most unusual sky. Not a sign of a cloud passing by. If my heart won't behave in the usual way.
Experience the power of sanctuary at the Lincoln Wishlist event.
At Chipotle, real food always starts with real ingredients in real kitchens. When you order Chipotle, real food starts with you. Whether it's in restaurant, pickup, or delivery. However you Chipotle is the easiest way to Chipotle.
You clean dishes as you cook to save time and stay ahead of the mess. But scrubbing still takes time. Now there's Dawn Power Wash Dish Spray. The faster, easier way to clean as you go. It cleans grease five times faster. On easy messes, just spray, wipe, and rinse. On tough messes, the spray-activated suds cut through grease on contact without water. Just wipe and rinse. Get dishes done faster. Dawn Power Wash Dish Spray. Now available in free and clear.
You are trouble.
I did what I did to save my son, but this is not who I am.
I'm just a cleaning lady.
The Cleaning Lady, series premiere tomorrow on Fox.
Today's game is sponsored by Lincoln. This winter, wish for the unexpected.
Las Vegas Raiders back on top. Hunter Renfro, first career 1,000-yard season. You had Jones earlier in that drive, first career 100-yard game.
Yeah, talking about a lot of firsts. And look, whatever it takes.
Carr hoping to start a playoff game for the first time
exactly.
in his career.
Whatever it takes, man. You see that Pro Bowler Max Crosby leading on his team. You got three really, really good players. You can build on those guys.
Renfro, only six receptions today, 98 on the season, trailing only Tim Brown among Raider wide receivers.
Yeah, look who he surpassed, Jerry Rice. And we have been putting some graphics out here, some chyrons that have been just absolutely insane with the names that these players are passing up.
Think Coach Madden will be into this game?
Oh, he would love it.
Rodgers lets it go. Week 18, next weekend. Matchup times and networks will be determined following this week's games. A lot could happen between now and tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah. These games have been as good as advertised. Look at the schedule, Kenny, down the wire.
Raiders, Chargers, week 18. The Colts will travel to Jacksonville. Carson Wentz and the Colts back to work from their 25-yard line as Perriman comes up to bring down Jonathan Taylor, set a franchise record for rushing yards in a single season earlier today.
Yeah, and there's Denzel Perriman making his first Pro Bowl. I've been watching him, Kenny, literally since high school. Wow. Went to the same high school as me, Coral Gables Senior High, then went on to University of Miami. And the thing he did was lose weight. He lost about 20 pounds this season because of that. He's able to slip these blocks, make the plays that he wasn't making the past few years. And the rest of the NFL took notice. Congrats to him on the Pro Bowl.
Following your path, now all he has to do is win a Super Bowl. Here's Taylor. Nice push. Taylor out to the 35-yard line, close to a first down.
Got to worry about this game first.
Yes.
We don't want to put him in the playoffs or the Super Bowl yet. And then there's Jonathan Taylor. You know how I knew that he's really coming along when we were talking with him? That graphic says everything you need to know. And he's at 95 yards. They're getting close. But when we were talking to him, he mentioned manipulating defensive tackles, manipulating the safeties. Like, that's not a second-year guy conversation you're having. That's a grown man. He knows exactly what he's doing.
There's Taylor once again, spinning for some extra yardage. He picks up five as we head for a game break. Carissa.
Thanks, Kenny. Bucks down 14. Tom Brady will connect with Cameron Brate on this four-yard score. But moments before that, Antonio Brown took his jersey off, left the field after throwing his other shirt and gloves into the stands. It was reported that Mike Evans tried to calm him down, but to no avail. Bucks down by seven. Sarah, you'll have plenty to talk about at Bucks Camp tomorrow.
Wow. Would not be surprised if that's the last we see of Antonio Brown in a Bucks uniform.
Yeah, or in any uniform.
Or without a uniform.
Yeah.
Penalty marker as we check in with Sarah. Following the announcement from the referee, Rogers.
Offense, number 72. 10-yard penalty, second down.
Sarah.
Well, back on the line this week, Ryan Kelly, who missed last week's game after his wife Emma suffered a miscarriage. Kelly addressed the media this week, thanking the organization and the Colts community for the outpouring of love and support. Frank Reich told us he doesn't usually watch player pressers, but made it a point to hear Kelly's, and he said he was a role model in how to handle grief while showing vulnerability and strength at the same time. To the Kelly family, our hearts are with you and Mary Kate, and applaud your honesty and courage in sharing your story with everyone.
Thanks, Sarah. Frank Reich also used the words class and dignity when referring to the press conference held by Kelly earlier this week.
Said it was the best speech he had heard. The message was as good as you can ever deliver in a situation like that.
Second down at 15. Pittman makes the catch. Pittman out to the 42-yard line. Gain of 12. Third down and three. We approach 8 minutes on the clock. Fourth quarter in Indianapolis. Raiders with a three-point lead. Colts can clinch a playoff spot with a victory. Raiders control their own destiny.
If you notice, the Raiders, they only have one safety deep. That's because they're respecting the run game of Jonathan Taylor, even on third down.
Here's Wentz after the fake to Taylor. And Carson Wentz doing his best Jonathan Taylor impersonation. Picks up the Colts first down.
Nice self-scout by Frank Reich. Everyone recognizing Jonathan Taylor gets the ball on third and short. So what do? Keep it with Carson Wentz. Gets just enough yards, and I love that he just slides, take it, and move on. Frank Reich with a nice play call to keep the sticks moving.
New set of downs for the Colts.
34.
From the 49-yard line, off the fake to Taylor. Wentz wrapped up. escapes. Oh. And now throws, trying to make something out of nothing, looking for Mo Alie-Cox. But from a Colts standpoint, at least, he was not sacked.
Yeah, how did Nate Hogg coming in, how does he miss this? He goes, he's getting blocked by Jonathan Taylor. One 1,000, two 1,000, Wentz senses it. He's trying to go. You got to secure the tackle first. Yeah, he's going for the football, I understand. But it's always, you're always taught first man, secure the tackle, then go for the football.
Second and 10. Wentz steps up.
Nice play.
Take it down at midfield. Darius Filon. Third and long coming up for Indianapolis.
Yeah, this is really good coverage. Roderick Teamer, Desmond Trufant reading that beautifully. You see the over route was covered by the linebacker. That was a great job. And you see Carson Wentz, his eyes went through every one of his progressions. The best thing I see, though, is Darius Filon. He's watching Wentz, understands he scrambles, gets him down, gets into a third and long.
Colts just 2 for 9 on third down. They must get to the 41. Wentz fires, flag. Ooh.
I'm going to see the replay before I comment, Kenny.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 39. Ball is placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
The live shot, it did not look like pass interference on Nate Hobbs. Right here, they were playing press man. They really all just knew they're going to stop at the sticks. And it looked like he just played them perfectly. He stops, he squats, they both squat down. I've seen worse, Kenny. Saw a little tug of the jersey, but I've seen a lot worse for pass interference.
Hobbs agrees with you.
Wentz does not. Looked like he was just saying thank you, yelling at me.
So the drive continues for the Colts from the Raiders 39-yard line. Here's Taylor. He's over 100 yards this afternoon. As we mentioned, Colts 9-0 when Taylor runs for at least 100.
Yes, and we're going to show you all the great plays because he's such a special back. What we're not showing you is that he'll run for a yard, 2 yards. They stick with it. And I love that when they stick with it, he gains confidence, the offensive line gains confidence, and this is the play that broke the single-season rushing record. I love that the Colts stopped for. Edgerrin James gave him a shout-out afterwards. Just a fun guy to watch. Yep.
Second down and 6. Here's Taylor. Jonathan, I've spoken to some folks at the University of Wisconsin who know him well, and they said, as good as he is on the field, he's an even better person.
We can sense that when we interviewed with him. As you see, 10th game, 100-plus rush yards this season. When we interviewed with him, he was still talking about how he has things he wants to improve upon. He wants to now be a threat in the passing game more, as good as he's done in the running game. I mean, everything about him says, I'm hungry, I'm determined, I'm ready to lead. It's just been great, man. You don't see that too often, right? These good guys that are really humble. I love it.
The 1,000-yard games for Taylor, a new franchise record. Third down and 3. Wentz throws, caught. Taylor, first down.
Not a big threat in the passing game, but very impactful. That was a third down. Recognize Denzel Perriman goes on a linebacker blitz. The check down's going to be open. Make yourself available. Him and Wentz on the same page. And this drive has been a really good drive. They've converted. They were just horrible at third down. They've converted so far on this drive.
7-minute drive for Indianapolis, trailing by 3. Under 4 minutes remaining as Nate Hobbs brings down Taylor.
You know, they're already in field goal range. Gus Bradley looking on, trying to figure out what he should call. But if I'm the offense, I'm already in field goal range. I would want to take a shot into the end zone. You can get a tie game, but you don't want to give Derek Carr the ball, three timeouts, and then just bleed the clock to the end for a last-second field goal. I would love to see Wentz and the offense take a shot. As you see, they're going empty here, motioning Naheem Hines across the field.
Second down and nine. Quick out, caught by Hines. Well, the Raider defense comes up big.
Yeah, I don't like that. If you're going to do that, you might as well run the ball with Taylor. You would have gotten the same production, a couple yards, if not better, with Taylor running the football.
Down to 3 minutes on the clock. Third down and nine for Indianapolis. They are 2 for 2 on third down on this drive.
They bring in what's called 10 personnel, which is four wide receivers, one running back, no tight ends. Get back to a bunch look at the bottom of the screen. Frees up those two off-the-ball wide receivers. They won't face press man.
Third down and nine. Wentz, under pressure, flips it to Hines. So this time the Colts unable to capitalize on third down. And they will send out the field goal unit in an attempt to tie this game. Clock winding down towards the 2 minute warning.
Yeah, Colts got a little too conservative offensively those last few plays. If you're going to run the ball, run the ball.
It will be a 41-yard attempt. When we return, three-point game in Indianapolis.
All right, here we go. Miller in motion. Wait, is that a baby on the field?
It looks like it, Craig.
And the defensive linemen are playing peekaboo. I've never seen anything like that before.
Harris now appears to be burping the baby.
That's a great moment right there.
Ref going to the rule book here.
Well, wait a minute. Harris is off to the races.
We don't need any more trick plays.
Touchdown!
But we could all use more ways to save.
Are you kidding me?
That's got to be a long bus ride home for the defense.
Switch to Geico for more ways to save.
At Lowe's, with endless ways to organize what you need, you'll find some of the peace of mind you want at prices you really want. Start the year fresh at Lowe's. Shop Lowe's Store and Save event now, in-store and online.
You could fret about that email you just sent with a typo. And most of the info is totally outdated. Or you could use Slack and edit your message after it's sent. Whew. Slack, where the future works.
Who has live TV? Hulu has live sports?
They do.
It also has over 75 live channels.
Woo! Flip like cable, stream like Hulu.
The BK $5 Your Way meal is here to make your choice easy and so tasty. Go straight to the Double Whopper Jr. with piping hot small fries, four-piece crispy nuggets, and a refreshing small drink. Can you believe you get all this for only $5? The $5 Your Way meal, only at Burger King.
Week 17 continues later today on CBS and Fox, then tonight on NBC. Tune in tomorrow for Monday Night Football on ESPN. Stream games on mobile with the Yahoo Sports and NFL apps.
Today's game is sponsored by Burger King. Get the $5 Your Way meal with the Double Whopper Jr.
Coming up next, America's Game of the Week. Dallas Cowboys, Arizona Cardinals. Some of you will see the Lions and Seahawks, Panthers, Saints. Check local listings for the game. In your area, Cowboys have clinched the East. Cardinals have clinched a berth. How about the playoff picture and these pictures in the NFC?
Yes, says it all, man. You see the leaders of the team. You see who's clinched. Wild card race going down to the wire, just as everyone's expected. And we're going to see it's going to clear up after a couple of these games. And next week is going to be just as fun as we've had today, Kenny. I know that for a fact.
9 minute, 18 minute drive, longest of the season for Frank Reich's Colts, but Raiders keep them out of the end zone. Here's Badgley, a 41 yard attempt from the right hash for the tie. The kick is straight through. With a minute 56 remaining. Biggest kick of the season to this point. We are tied at 20.
Next question.
Archie, is this your first meeting with Caesar and Cleopatra?
We met in Miami in 2007.
Ah, the helmet catch. Right, Eli?
Actually, that was 2008 in Phoenix. Miami was Peyton's first Super Bowl.
Also great,
but not as great as the helmet catch.
I would have hit him in the numbers, probably.
Who cares? We're all Caesars. Am I right? Even Cooper. He's my favorite.
Happy holidays, everyone.
Nice.
We are all Caesars, and the Mannings are also Caesars.
When does an underdog stop being an underdog? After the first big win? The second? Try never. Because being an underdog isn't about how much you win. It's about how hard you're willing to work for it. And making sure your opponents never know your next move. Which is why some of us make a point of staying underdogs. Even when we're on top. Ram Trucks, J.D. Power's number one brand in new vehicle quality.
Pizza Hut's stuffed crust is the crust that made crust good. Topped and stuffed with over a half pound of cheese. What are you so afraid of? Loving it? Original stuffed crust, just $12.99. Only from Pizza Hut. No one out pizza the Hut.
A record-breaking storm hits Texas.
This is Captain Owen Strand requesting emergency assistance.
I don't know if I'll be able to fix this.
Let's move!
911 Lone Star season premiere, followed by the premiere of The Cleaning Lady, tomorrow on Fox.
Seton Hall clashes with UConn. And Michigan State battles Michigan. College hoops tip off Saturday at 11:30 Eastern on Fox.
This game has lived up to its billing. Under 2 minutes remaining, tied at 20. Both teams control their own destiny. Raiders win their last two, clinch a playoff berth. Colts clinch with a victory today.
The intensity has been there from the start, Kenny. Raiders deliver the first blow. Colts answer back. I mean, what more could we ask for from this game? We've had big plays, we've had interceptions, we've had sacks.
The decision by Rich Bisaccia to go for it on fourth down, yes. And Raiders scored a touchdown.
We even have broken records, rush records, receptions. I mean, this is crazy.
28 career game-winning drives. When the Raiders last made it to the postseason in 2016, he was out. He'd love to get there for the first time.
Okay. Jacobs is back in as well. That's going to help out. Too high safety look from the Colts.
Both teams with all three timeouts. Carr's pass complete for the tight end, Moreau. That's his first catch today. Gain of 9. Stay with us. State Farm game break. Coming up next. And then America's game of the week. Week 17. Second down and 1. Carr got rid of it at the last possible second. And it's caught by Jacobs for a Raiders first down.
There was pretty pay coming around the corner. And then DeForest Buckner steps in there. As soon as he steps up, DeForest Buckner is there. Derek Carr gets the ball up just in time.
Carr on first down, caught across midfield at the Colts territory by Jones. Gain of 14.
Timeout is called.
Raiders use their first, 61 seconds remaining.
Yeah, they're playing two-man Colts defense. Everyone has man. They're trying to drive him inside. You see Kyrie Willis, he was supposed to be the robber, but Derek Carr read that so quickly. Zay Jones got inside him, played right off the leverage to get that easy first down, that long completion. There's someone like Derek Carr who's seen it all. I don't know if disguising is the best thing. You know,
watching Carlson getting ready for the kick, but disguising, I don't think it's the best thing. You see these safeties back there. I would just line them up in exactly what you want and focus on getting pressure up front.
Carr steps up and then throws it away in the vicinity of Renfro. Carlson's career long is 56. He's two for two today.
And they continuing to bring this pressure from the side, from his left side. DeForest Buckner's been doing a really good job as well. Taylor Stallworth is getting in there. That's what's going to help you the most with Derek Carr. It's not going to be disguising the coverage, trying to confuse him. It's speeding up that clock, make him throw the football faster than when he wants to.
Down to 58 seconds. Empty backfield, second and 10.
Oh,
what was Carr looking for there?
Carr was looking for Brian Edwards. He saw the safety come down and go and take the back, so it leaves the middle of the field wide open.
Third down and 10. Carr under pressure. Now he throws, and it's caught by Renfro for a first down. He's still going to the end zone. Touchdown!
Oh, my goodness! Derek Carr puts it only where Hunter Renfro could get that ball. Kenny Moore undercut him. Never touched him. Renfro goes down. He was not touched by Kenny Moore. Gets right back up for the touchdown. Kenny Moore had undercut that beautifully. And Derek Carr, scrambling for his life, able to get the ball over the top where only Renfro could get it. And we just talked about too much time for Derek Carr, a little conservative offensively for the Colts on that previous series. And boy, did he just make magic happen.
All scoring plays are reviewed. Rod Rogers making sure he was not touched by Kenny Moore.
No, he wasn't, at least from that angle. We saw it live. We saw one of the replay angles. Did not look like he was touched.
Let's welcome in Mike Pereira from Los Angeles. Mike, what did you see or not see?
Yeah, it's really close, because what you're going to watch is the left hand touching the right foot. Right there, you watch the finger get bent back there. If, in fact, they've got the shot that shows that he does touch him there, then they will put him down when he gets to the ground. So that's the one thing they're going to focus on.
All right, thanks, Mike.
Great catch, Mike.
Now, if he was ruled down, the Raiders could run some time and then set up for a field goal. If it's ruled a touchdown, at least the Colts would have some time.
Yeah, and there's a finger. Here comes the finger. Right there, index, middle, ring finger. Great catch, Mike Pereira.
It was ruled a touchdown on the field.
That's the hand right there, Kenny. And
there must be indisputable visual evidence in order to overturn the call on the field.
Yeah, it looks like Carr is coming back on the field. But you said it best. If I'm the Colts, I'd rather they just score a touchdown. Give me the time.
Right. Now the Colts might not get the ball back.
Exactly. Exactly. But then you can say, well, they might miss the field goal. True. True. We'll see what happens. A lot of love for Carson Wentz, if I'm the Colts or a Colts fan, to have the ball in his hands to try and make a play.
Rod Rogers back on headset. And we welcome in Mike Pereira once again. Mike.
Yeah, since they're reversing this to him being down, that's actually reversing him to a running clock. If they'd have ruled it properly, the clock would have remained running. So what they're talking about is the 10-second runoff that goes with this.
After review, the runner was down at the 24-yard line. The defender's hand touched his shoe. Please set the game clock to 48 seconds. Indianapolis has chosen to take a timeout to avoid the 10-second runoff, the 10-second subtraction. It will be first down.
All right, thanks, Mike. Thanks to Brad Rogers for the explanation. Colts will take a timeout to avoid the 10-second runoff. But like we said, if the touchdown stood, Colts know they're getting the ball back. Now they might not.
Yeah, you know, these Colts fans are very smart. You notice only a few of them cheered when they heard that the touchdown was being taken off the board. They understand this is not better for us, that there is hope still, of course. But I'd almost rather have Carson Wentz with three timeouts and a bunch of time go down the field and try to tie it.
Instead, it's a first down from the 24-yard line of Indianapolis. Jacobs picks up three. And now a timeout taken by the Colts. 44 seconds on the scoreboard clock. Colts down to one timeout. Colts with a win today would clinch a playoff berth. Vegas, they win their two games, and they are in.
Yes, that is why this game was so intense, so important. Both teams controlling their own destiny.
We're good, we're good. Simpson.
Second down and eight. Jacobs to the Colts 17. Colts is their final timeout. Down to 39 seconds.
And there's Daniel Carson, kicker for the Raiders. There's Leonard. Forced a fumble, had a beautiful interception. Big time player stepped up today.
39 seconds remaining. Colts out of timeouts.
And Colts have to be very careful. It's a third and three. Josh Jacobs, if they run the ball and he gets his first down, now you really won't have a chance offensively.
Well, they won't anyway, because the Raiders will let the clock run all the way down here.
Yep.
Down to 25 seconds. Colts can't stop it. Raiders will let it run all the way down, and then here's a timeout before setting out the field goal unit on fourth down. 10 seconds. Now down to five, and the timeout will be taken by the Raiders. Here comes the field goal unit and Daniel Carlson. So again, that tough call. The finger of Kenny Moore making contact with Hunter Renfro, ruled down by contact, and that took away the possibility of the Colts getting the ball back.
That really hurt them. Really, really hurt them.
So we are down to 2 seconds on the clock as Carlson will set up for a 33-yard attempt for the win. 2 seconds remaining. Tied at 20. Carlson from 33. His kick is good. Raiders win. What a game.
Ice in Derek Carr's veins.
The game winner from Carlson for Jonathan Millman, Sarah Walsh, and Kenny Albert. Now to Kurt Menefee in Los Angeles, State Farm.